Hello. So I spent like yesterday and today writing a new software with LabVIEW to create a multi-track recorder. As you can see, I'm about to lose being able to use LabVIEW. This is only an evaluation version. They'll let me use another evaluation version, after in the next quarter. Next quarter, every 3 months. So this is a multi-track recorder, and what you'll see is there's nothing, no folder against this multi-track recorder right now. It's going to be created once I start this software. Here it is. So you'll see it pop up over here as soon as it starts. I got to update it. I got to refresh the window. So I refresh, and now it pops up. And you can tell it just loaded. It's September 12, 2024, 6:31 p.m. You can see it's brand new. I just created that records log. When I stop and restart, it records a new stop and restart every time. So now I got to reopen the file, and now you'll see another re it just restarted. So you know that I just created this folder. So now what I'm going to do is create a new song. And in here, you'll see that it created a new song and it has folders. And inside here is going to be the tracks. And inside this main song zero will be the final file. It'll be a WAV file, but I can convert it to MP3. It's not difficult to do. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a few tracks because you have to add tracks to be able to record. So I'm just going to add a few in here. What I learned was when I was writing music and playing guitar and stuff like that, sometimes I'd use 10, 11 tracks for a song. Sometimes I might use more. I'd have three guitar tracks for well, three tracks for guitar, maybe three or four for drums, stuff like that, and two or three for vocals. Anyway, I got 10 tracks selected. I'm not going to use them all. I just show you that they're there. So now I'm going to open this software over here, which is where I'm going to play a few songs. And I've kind of predetermined what I want to play based on the sound of the music. It's not so loud that it overwhelms the other music that's playing. So we'll go ahead and go to the first track. I'm going to go ahead and record on the first track, and that's the song I want to record. So I'll stop that one there. Now I'll go to the next track, and I'm going to play something a little bit different on this one. I've predetermined what I'll play based on the volume of the song. That way you can hear the other songs as they start to play and things like that. Because if one's too loud, it will overwhelm the other songs. So now I'm going to go to track. Let's do it on just track three. We'll record on track three. And I'm gonna cut it off there because I kind of started early, and then just to let you know it's still playing, I'm gonna join in right here again. And that might be where you can determine, there's multiple songs playing at the same time. I kind of messed up my plans on that one, but that's what it is. So now I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna pick another song, and I'm gonna put it down here on track five, and I want to pick a Dream Theater song. I used to listen to them all the time. This one, this is a good one, and because it comes in so loudly, it's so loud when it joins in, so I'm going to bring in and right about this area just so you can hear it come in and cut back out. So, okay, so I kind of messed up on that again. That's all right. You'll be able to hear that play and then that jump in. So And one last song, I'm gonna throw one last one in here. I'll put it down here on track 9. And this is one that I'm gonna start it before I start recording. That way you'll hear it actually, you'll hear some of it's missing as it's playing. Where's it at? One more song. Let's do this. That's what I was looking for. So I'll record it on this one. Okay, I'll go ahead and stop it. Now I'm going to show you some of the features that are on this. So first, you see all the ones I've just recorded. I'll go ahead and just start from the beginning. So here's the first. It's just a short part of the song. It recorded what? So that's the first one. You can see this one's here. So you can see this is going to work as it's going to work great as a multi-track recorder when I finish the software. But first thing, before I can finish the software, I'm going to have to I'm going to have to wait for a few months so I can get the evaluation software again. Okay, so you can see that one worked. I'll go ahead and close that. And then the last one was Fury Lease. So now I'm going to show you, it takes all of these and plays them one at a time, and it's already, you know, it's got the full recording, all of them mixed together. So it works as a multi-track recorder. Like I said, I've only worked on this for a couple of days, so this is just my first shot at trying to make this thing work if I wanted to. But I can just keep adding more and more tracks. As you can see, I'm just adding more tracks. Just keep going. I don't know the limitation. Probably whatever's on the hard drive or whatever I need for the song. Anyway,